Okay, our first integration rule is called the constant rule, and it asks if you take the integral of a constant, what is it that you get? Well, it turns out if this is a constant, then the integral of a constant will be a linear expression. So we'd say kx. So if this was the integral of 5, we'd say 5x. Now, because this is an indefinite integral, we always have to add in the constant of integration is plus c, so let's not forget about that. Now, just real briefly, the reason for this is pretty clear. If your function is a constant, well, then we know that the derivative of a constant would be zero, right? Because if you drew a constant function at 4 or 7 or -2, a flat line, if you drew that function, it would have a slope of zero everywhere. But if you asked what function, if you took its derivative, would give you a constant, well, then it would have to be basically like y equals mx plus b. Now, here we're saying kx plus b, but the k would be the slope. So it would be equivalent to like your m, so to speak, in your old algebra classes where you learn linear functions. And sure enough, if you have a linear expression like this, what's the slope of this linear expression? What's the k, right? And so we see if this is the original function and this is the derivative of that function, we would call this expression capital F, or the antiderivative of the function, also known as the indefinite integral. So it's not a very hard rule to use at all. It's very straightforward. Here's three easy examples. You really can't make these too difficult. The integral of -2 would simply be -2x plus c, right? -2x plus any constant. This guy's derivative would be -2 if you went kind of in the reverse direction. 7/2 is a fraction, but that doesn't matter. We just say 7/2 x plus c. And the integral of pi is 3.14159 and continues on for forever. It'd simply be pi x plus c. The only mistake I usually see from students in regards to the constant rule here is a lot of students will forget and think that the integral is zero, like a derivative of a constant would be zero, but that's not the case. Just remember to make it a linear expression and you should be fine.